Does it take you time to find the equations on the reference handbook? Or maybe you have taken the FE exam before and you notice that the computers are slow and it really takes time to navigate through the reference handbook. Well, in this video, I'm going to share with you guys methods that I use to quickly find the equations on the reference handbook. Now, these tips and tricks that I'm about to share with you guys, they work and they will help you pass the FE exam, but you'll only find them right here. So keep watching. Oh yeah, everybody now. For those of you guys who don't know me already, my name is Kenza and I've helped hundreds of students pass the FE exam. Now, before we get started, I just want you guys to know that a lot of the examples that I'm going to use here are going to be based on sections under FE Civil, Mechanical, and other disciplines. Now, however, you can still apply the same exact tips to any FE exam. Now, the first thing we're going to go over here is locating the tables. Now, let's go over the reference handbook and I'm going to show you guys what I mean by that. Now, let's take a look at an example. So let's say you're trying to find the moment of inertia for a rectangle. And as most of you guys know, the equation for the moment of inertia of the rectangle is under a table, which is under statics. Now, if we click statics here, the first couple pages are all equations. Now, if we go a little bit more down, then we have the tables. So the tables are located at the end of statics. Now, the question is there a faster way to get to these tables? And the answer is yes. See, if we click here dynamics and if we scroll up, that will actually take us directly to the tables. So if you want to get to the moment of inertia tables, just remember that you can just click dynamics and scroll up versus clicking statics and then scrolling down all the way to the end of the statics section. Now, what you guys need to do is try to remember the tables that are under each section. So, for example, here, as we mentioned, under statics, at the end of statics, we have these tables here. And note, guys, how I clicked dynamics and I scrolled up to get to them. Now, if we want to go to the tables that are under dynamics, what I'm going to do is click mechanics of materials, and then I'm going to scroll up. And this will take me to these tables here, which has mass and centroid equations, mass moment of inertia, and radius of duration of these shapes, and then also these shapes here. Now, if we want to get to the tables that are under mechanics of materials, I'm going to click thermo, and then I'm going to scroll up here, and then I went a little too far. Here, what we have is the slope, deflection, and the maximum moment for cantilevered beam. So that's what this table is. For this table is for simply supported beam. If we go up one more page here, we have mechanical properties for certain materials. And then lastly, we have this table here, which has material properties also for certain materials. So we have modulus of elasticity, modulus of rigidity, and so on, okay? Now, the last section that I would like to cover here is fluid mechanics. See, under fluid mechanics, we have the famous Moody chart, which I recommend that you guys remember where it is so that you can get to the chart as fast as you can because it is common on the FE exam. Now, to get to it, what we're going to do here is click heat transfer, and then we're going to scroll up. The thing what you need to remember is that it's not really the last graph that we have, so you're gonna have to go up a couple times before you get to it, and there we go, we have the Moody chart. Now, not all subjects have the tables at the end of the section. Sometimes the tables are in the middle of the section. So clicking on the next section and scrolling up won't work in this situation. So what do you do? Well, let's go back to the reference handbook and let's take a look at an example. If we take a look at math, which is a large section, it is easy to remember that the straight line equations are located on the second page, which I recommend that you guys remember that for your FE exam, but it is hard to locate the derivative and integrals tables because they are kind of located in the middle of the section. So in this case, it would actually be easier to just type the keywords than scrolling up and down. Now, don't forget, guys, that you can also look up the keywords on the reference handbook, but sometimes when there is an equation that is under a table and you know where that table is, it is just faster to go to the table, grab the equation, and start solving the problem. So just something to keep in mind for your FE exam. And by the way, guys, if you are enjoying this video, make sure to like and subscribe to learn more tips and tricks on how you can pass your FE exam. Another thing we're going to look at here is trying to remember just approximately where certain equations are on the reference handbook. And I'm going to walk you guys through some examples, but you need to keep in mind that this will take you some time. And also while studying for the FE, make sure that you guys are always using your reference handbook as a PDF file. And also when you are studying and using equations, try to be aware of this and always take a moment and see where the equation is on the reference handbook with respect to the section. Now let's take a look at an example. So let's say you're doing a problem on dynamics and the problem is on rectilinear motion. Now you should remember that rectilinear motion equations are located at the beginning of the dynamics section. In fact, they are on the second page of dynamics, and you should actually remember this for EFE because it is common. Now if we scroll down a little bit more here, we're going to have projectile motion equations. If we go a little bit more, we have work and energy, we have kinetic energy, potential, work, power and efficiency, and then we have momentum. All these are a little bit in the middle of the dynamic section. Now, what I recommend is just knowing the big concepts, just approximately where they are located with respect to the rest of the section. Are they at the beginning of the section? Are they in the middle? Or are they at the end? This way, or just knowing where they are just approximately, can really help you grab the equation real fast during the FE and solve the problem faster. Another section that I would recommend that you guys go over is fluid mechanics. See, fluid mechanics has so many equations and so many concepts, and just knowing where certain concepts, especially the common ones, where they are with respect to the rest of the section, it's really going to help you grab the equations or find the equations faster during the FE exam. So for example, here, the first page, we just have definition of density, specific volume, specific weight, and so on. Then we have stress and viscosity equations. Here we have the equation for pressure. We have manometers, which is important to know for the FE. We also have forces on submerged surfaces. Then we have continuity equation. We have energy equation, Bernoulli equation. So all these are important to kind of just know approximately where they are. Now, if you are taking FE Civil or if you are taking FE Environmental, another section I recommend that you guys take some time to go over is Environmental Engineering. Environmental Engineering is a very large section, and it covers air pollution, wastewater, water treatment plants, landfill, air, all of that. So it has so many concepts, and it's very important that you kind of know where each of the concepts or each of the main subtopics are located in the section, so that it helps you grab the equations faster during your FE. With that being said, I am not saying that you guys should remember where the equations are on the reference handbook. And sometimes it is just faster to look up the keywords than scrolling to the reference handbook. But sometimes it is just faster to know where just certain equations are. And also, by knowing where certain equations are going to help you a lot when you are actually solving the problems. See, when you're going to start visualizing where the equations are on the reference handbook, as you're solving problems, you're going to start thinking about the equations that you're going to need, and you're going to even visualize where they are, and then you're going to be able to grab them faster. And even if you don't grab them right away, even if you look up, let's say, the keyword, when you look up the keyword, if you click on a page like that is not the correct page, you'll be able to notice it right away, and you're going to move on to the next search, and that will save you a lot of time. So it's very important that you guys take some time and just go through the equations that are given to you on the reference manual. Now, I would also recommend that you guys check out this video right here where I talk about 5 tips on how to effectively use the reference handbook. Another thing I want to share with you guys in this video is that our course bundle is currently on sale, and it is going to expire on October 8th. Now, you're probably wondering, why should you take our course? See, this year alone, we have helped hundreds of students pass the FE exam, and just last week, 3 students passed the FE, and one of them, she took the FE exam several times and she couldn't pass it, not because she didn't study or because she has been out of school for a while, but because she lacked motivation and reliable resources. She enrolled in our program, and 2 months later, she passed her FE exam. Now, if you want to pass your FE, our course can really help you achieve that goal and faster. So make sure that you guys enroll soon before the sale expires. Now, the last thing we're going to go over here is civil engineering. So civil engineering section is a large section and it contains a lot of topics. So we have geotechnical engineering, structure analysis, structural design, hydrology, water resources, transportation, surveying, and then construction. Now let's go to the reference handbook and let's take a look at it together. Now, what you guys need to remember is that the first topic we have under civil engineering is geotechnical engineering. So now if you get a problem, let's say on phase relationships, you can just click on civil engineering and then you'll get directly to the equations for phase relationships. Now, if you have a problem on, let's say, liquid limits, which we have here, or consolidation or settlement, or stress or shear, you can just scroll down and you'll get to those equations. Now you're probably asking, hey Kenza, why can't we just look up the keywords, right? So that can become tricky, especially, so for example, if we take a look at stress is covered in so many different sections, right? So we have 174 results. And the first stress you're gonna click on, it's gonna take you to mechanics and materials. But if you know that the problem you're working with is under geotechnical engineering, then it will actually just be faster to go to civil engineering, go to that first section and scroll down till you hit the equations for stress. And the same thing for shear. So if we actually type shear, we're gonna get 89 searches or results, right? So these are just tips and tricks that you can remember on how to get to the equations faster when looking up the keywords might actually not help you. Now, what if you're doing a problem on construction or surveying? How do you get to those sections? Because they are at the end of civil engineering. And if you started civil engineering and you scroll down all the way to the end, it's gonna take you a lot of time. So what you can do is just click environmental engineering and then you can scroll up and that will take you directly to the construction equation. So this is all for construction. If we scroll up one more page, we have surveying. And if we go again one more page, we're gonna have pavement design, which is under transportation. So after this is all going to be transportation. We have traffic flow, and then we're gonna find horizontal and then the vertical curves. So what you guys need to remember is that the first we have is geotech, and then at the end, if you're trying to get equations for construction or surveying or transportation and looking up the keywords might not help you, then remember to click on environmental engineering and then you can just scroll up to get to those sections. Now let's take a look at another example that involves steel and concrete. Now let's say you're doing a problem and you are asked to find the moment of a steel beam. So if we try to type moment, we're gonna get so much results. We're gonna get 151 results. And if we type, let's say beam, we are going to get 46. Now let's type steel. We're going to get 45. That's still a lot of results. And it's going to be at the end because civil engineering section is at the end. So how do you get to the moment of a steel beam faster, right? So that's the question. So there are two ways you can do this. You can click civil engineering and scroll down because you know that the equation is going to be under the steel section, which is under structural design, which is under civil engineering, right? So you can click civil engineering, scroll down all the way to steel section, which is gonna take you a lot of time. So if we keep going here, so here we have analysis, then I hit concrete, and then after concrete, we have steel, and there you go. So that took a little bit of time, but for the FE, if you wanna get it faster, what you can do here is just type in structural. So let me write it down, structural design. And if we do that and we click the first result, we're gonna go directly to structural design. We go down a little bit, we're gonna hit concrete, and then there you go, we have steel. So what you need to do is find these different methods that's going to help you to get to certain sections, certain equations faster. So these are the methods that I found while I was studying for the FE on how to quickly find the equations on the reference handbook. And you guys might find other methods as well, but the only way to do that is by using the reference handbook as a PDF all the time whenever you're studying for the FE exam. And also, if you have found other methods that you found helpful and they helped you find the equations faster, please share them with us in the comments below. Last week, we did a mastermind where I answered so many questions about the FE. Now, if you missed it, you can sign up in the link in the description below. Now, also, next week's video, I'm going to share with you guys the units that you should remember for your FE exam. So if you're excited about the video, make sure to comment excited. If you're trying to pass your FE exam and you are working full-time, you have a family, you failed the FE exam before, and you just have no idea what to do next, make sure that you guys watch Jacqueline's interview. She's a mother of two. She graduated in 2013. She was working full-time, and she shares her story on how she passed her FE exam on her fourth attempt. Now, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next week. À la prochaine. Oh, yeah.